Fawning cover is very important to make sure that we can protect fawns during those first few weeks of life when predators want to get every one of them and make sure that they get a good start. Now, depending on where you are, ideal fawning cover can take the form of a young forest where you have a lot of structure from a bunch of stems in a forest that provides great cover and concealing. You can do the same thing from an early successional vegetation standpoint in an old field where you have tall vegetation that's herbaceous rather than woody that provides excellent hiding cover, and at the same point, a bunch of food. And in some cases, you can even do the same thing by some of the food plots that we have. There are some food plot species that get a little bit taller that very young fawns can hide in as well. So there's no one specific plant or woody species that is better than another. You take what your environment offers and then just make sure that within that, that you get really good structure, low at ground level to hide those fawns and provide them the absolute best opportunity to survive. I think some of the great ways to be able to implement fawning cover is take what you have. Say if we're in a forested area, you want to make sure that you can provide a lot of sunlight to the ground such that we get a flush of vegetation to want to be able to grow. Perfect example is if you have aspen in your area. Aspen is a species that is a prolific shooter out of the roots. So if you cut a big aspen down, it will send up hundreds of shoots, and then over the course of a growing season can be 3, 4, 5 feet tall and provide exceptional cover for fawns and a whole host of other wildlife species in those areas. Another good example, if you don't have aspen in your area, is any type of hardwood forest. As long as you can get enough sunlight to the ground, you can get great fawning cover. So you can go in and you can cut some of those trees, you can girdle and spray some of those trees, anything to be able to kill them such that sunlight gets out of that canopy and right to the ground and you get that flush of vegetation, which can then provide exceptional fawning cover. Now, if you're looking at providing fawning cover outside of a forested area, maybe you don't have woods that you can dedicate to that, or maybe you don't have any woods at all, and there's lots of places that deer live that have very few trees, you can have exceptional fawning cover in an old field situation where you get rid of those cool season perennial grasses. Deer don't need those. They're not going to eat them anyway. Replace those with broadleaf plants, and you can do this without having to plant anything. Just use an herbicide to kill the grasses. You get those broadleaf plants back, and then with that, you can get great structure, great cover for fawns as well as adults. And at the same time that you get that cover, you also get exceptional deer food value. So you really get two for the price of one in those old field environments. With respect to managing old fields like this early successional vegetation, the goal is get rid of those grasses and turn this into forbs and broadleaf plants. Both provide cover or structure, but the forbs or broadleafs are also providing food that the grasses don't. So if you're gonna have something there that's providing cover, why not have the free food with it as well? So what you see behind us, we have transitioned this from an old pasture, 100% cool season perennial grasses, into these broadleaf plants. So we're getting a really high quality deer field here. We're about 2 years into this, so we still have a long way to go. We'll get additional height, we'll get additional diversity with these plants, but right now we have come a long way enhancing the quality for deer. Now, one of the things when you're doing this, timing wise, how we get rid of these grasses, this is a good way to think about it. Any disturbance that you do during the growing season, the response is typically grass is what you get back, and that's what you don't want. So that's why a lot of the work that we do is during the dormant season. We can disc this during the dormant season and get broadleaves. If we disc it during the growing season, we get grass. If we spray it just during the growing season, we get grass. If we spray this at the end of the growing season or just into the beginning of the dormant season, we get broadleaves. And to completely highlight this, I'll show you, we actually would come in this spring and wanted to plant a screen of corn to a stand that we have through this. And you can see with a lot of broadleaf stuff, we're looking good. We had an extremely wet spring, way too wet. We knew we should have been planting rice instead of corn, but we gave it a shot anyway. So if you follow me right over to here, and this was exactly the same, look where we just left all the broadleaves. Now we are into almost solid grass. This is because this is what we sprayed to plant corn. The planting didn't work out at all because of the wet conditions, but take a look at what's here. This is almost solid grass. That last year was broadleaf stuff. This is 100% a result of disturbance during the growing season. So disturbed during the growing season, you get grass you don't want. That's why you want to do your management during the end of the growing season or into the dormant season so that you get the response of those broadleaf plants and forbs, which is exactly what the deer are looking for.